Hello and welcome to the tech update of this week. Now, since the US banned the sales of advanced chipsets from companies such as TSMC and Qualcomm and other US chip manufacturers to Huawei, almost all Chinese tech firms, especially Chinese smartphone manufacturers who relied on these advanced chipsets, were in great distress over the fear that they might also get banned from having access to these advanced chipsets. Luckily for these firms, this ban was more focused on Huawei. To the shock of everyone, Huawei is still surviving for the past 4 years, even in the absence of the most advanced chipsets from TSMC and Qualcomm. Huawei seems to be taking yet another leap towards self-reliance in the area of chipsets, as latest updates confirm that Huawei, with the support of China's number one semiconductor manufacturer, SMIC, will soon be launching yet another flagship phone, that is the Mate 70 series, powered by 5-nanometer chipsets from SMIC. Now, this makes this smartphone the first ever flagship device to be released by Huawei as well as SMIC, powered by a 5-nanometer chipset. Now, as much as this is a great news, there is also another side of the story that has to do with the yields as well as the cost, which Huawei needs to address, which I will be talking about in today's update. As you already know, SMIC was able to build a 7-nanometer Qualcomm 9000S chipset, which allowed Huawei to release their first flagship line in August last year, since the US ban in 2020 that supported a 5G connection. As much as this was a great achievement by SMIC and Huawei, the performance of this chipset cannot be compared with the performance of the most advanced chipsets from TSMC and Qualcomm. But one can say that Huawei being able to sustain their position in the Chinese smartphone market without advanced chipsets cannot also be overlooked as well, because the Chinese smartphone market remains a very competitive market. So for Huawei to be able to survive in this market over the past years without advanced chipsets says a lot about Huawei's brand position and strength in the Chinese market as well. One of the biggest challenges for China as well as Chinese chip manufacturers has been the issue of the lack of advanced chip making equipment, which would have enabled China to manufacture advanced chipsets. For the past few years, SMIC has been making the effort towards the making of 5-nanometer chipsets, even with the absence of advanced lithography machines. And these efforts by SMIC seems to be paying off with this new achievement. What this new achievement suggests is the fact that SMIC has been able to use older deep ultraviolet lithography machines purchased before the US sanctions were imposed to manufacture 5-nanometer chipsets. This marks a great milestone for both Huawei and SMIC, our reason being that it will take them a step closer towards the making of 3-nanometer chipsets. As SMIC is set to start a mass production of these 5-nanometer chipsets for Huawei, major concerns here are the fact that because SMIC is using old DUV machines to manufacture these chipsets, the yields are not as high as compared to them using advanced chip making equipment, and also, the cost involved in the process is equally high. So, if Huawei is to use the more expensive 5-nanometer chipsets, the cost of Huawei smartphones will surely be shooting up, which therefore means that Huawei may also have to resort to selling their smartphones with a less profit margin on them. As it stands now, TSMC remains the largest chip manufacturer, generating over $18.5 billion on sales in the first quarter of this year, followed by Samsung with $3.5 billion, whilst SMIC remains the third largest chip maker with $1.75 billion. Now, with this new breakthrough by SMIC, SMIC is likely to increase their profitability as more Chinese firms will resort to buying their chipsets locally instead of importing them from other nations. And this has been your quick update for today. Kindly let me know what you think of this impressive breakthrough by SMIC and Huawei. And if you find this corner informative, kindly don't forget to subscribe so you don't miss my next update. Thank you so much and have a good day.